Good evening. Today we are going to be talking about the seventh item that corresponds to our announcement to cover the picture of what exists from the spirit's point of view. Basically, what we are heading up with all the seven presentations is a proposal based on my understanding of what actually is the divine plan. It's a very daring proposition because basically I am putting myself in front of the responsibility of deciphering God's thought. And that's not something that can be easily addressed. Now, nevertheless, I feel that I have a concrete proposal, and what I'm supposed to do today is try to formulate it into a product that people who will be aware of it, on the minimum, they will be able to consider the proposal as an item of interest, and on the basis of that, they could formulate their own opinion and judge me for that, as well as start understanding what really exists, not around us in a physical way, but metaphysically. So we come, in other words, in a position to conclusively describe what metaphysics is all about. Now, my work is distinguished from the point of view that it utilizes scientific thought as a way of formulating whatever information it's available to me. And this is why a lot of people who have studied in universities prefer to look at my work as a way that they can relate to much more than otherwise. So let's start really by considering the question of what is metaphysics. Now everybody knows what is physics. Basically, physics is what we can relate to on the basis of our physical senses. This is the element that differentiates the physical side versus something else. The four existential body model, which is the first model that I have developed years ago, tries to give us a lot of information about this differentiation. First of all, I'm positioning myself in such a way that I can claim that everything is energy. Question right away, what is energy? Well, wait a moment. The fact remains that most of the people, although they are talking about energy continuously, they don't know what is energy. So I will try to explain it from my point of view. So if everything is energy, and if this horizontal line really indicates the capability of our senses to give us a chance to become aware of something which we can communicate with our senses, what happens above this horizontal line? First of all, what exists in this model? We say that everything is energy. to be able to quantify the idea of energy, right away we have to introduce into our discussion certain parameters. And the two parameters that I opted to utilize in order to describe my cognitive structure that I call existential body model is frequency and energy density. Now, the energy frequency is inverse to the energy density, and its purpose is to give us a measure of the capability of creation. The energy frequency actually shows how strong is the capability to create along this two-dimensional surface. Another way to think about it is that this specific parameter indicates the capacity of becoming, of having, in other words, the capability to be able to formulate even new life. Becoming is very important as a derivative of frequency, and from the point of view of density, being the inverse of frequency, what we really have here is a measure of the fluidity that characterizes the energy. Now, this fluidity can be used also as a measure of seeing whether or not the particular energy of a specific density will be capable to be distinguished, to be discerned by our physical senses, because we should realize that our physical senses is the element which allows us to distinguish things. Whatever we consider as materialized and physical is nothing more than what our eye, our vision, our hearing, our tasting, our smelling, our touching capability allows us to. In other words, it's a very, very small component of what really exists. The theoretical physics nowadays realize that all we know from on the basis of our physical knowledge is only 3 to 4% of what exists. What about the rest? What about the rest? That's a very, very serious question. Doesn't it exist? And what is there, after all? Okay. I would just spend 5 or 10 minutes to these relationships, but we have to understand that what is there is extremely important, because what we have here can be shown that it's not just a small component of what exists, but is also the cause, the end result of what is up there. But first of all, let's consider the question, what is up there? Because this is a question that relates to what exists, really. Up here, there is a zone that has the highest possible frequency, which means the most active part of the energy from the point of view of capability to create, of becoming. So this is the zone that is occupied by the spirit. Now the spirit, as far as we are concerned, there is a great need to be in order to be able to define it, but just for the sake of our own discussion today, which is introduction to a model in reality at this point of time, we can think of it as our soul. Our soul is part of a spiritual entity that has created it. Okay? So the soul is coming down from the spiritual zone. Next to it, we have the so-called cognitive or mental level or layer, which is the result and the necessary ingredient of any creation, because it gives the specifications for something to be created, taking the power from the spirit that is supplying it. And what I would suggest right away at this level is that the capability of thinking, because this is what really implies by the cognitive level, is something that belongs to the spirit. It is the spirit that is thinking. So the cognitive layer is actually the processes that relate to the thought creation. The thought creation is coming down from this mental layer, and now we are moving to the astral or emotional layer, which is actually our physical double. You have to understand that our astral or emotional self is the real creation. All the creation that we are considering, I'm proposing to you that it's nothing more than emotionally based. Because, think about that. If the spirit is given the power of creation and is capable of thinking, and the thoughts that are provided by the spirit through the cognitive level can only create emotions, then this is where the creation is. Never forget that there is no emotions without thoughts. In order to be able to have any kind of creation, somebody has to specify it. Somebody has to think about that. Somebody has, in other words, to give some kind of description of what is to be created, even in terms of emotions. Then, the creation on the emotional level, actually, is in one-to-one correspondence with whatever our senses permit us to be aware of, which is our physical body. Therefore, the emotions passing from the astral or emotional layer to the physical layer, with the help of the one-to-one correspondence that exists between the energetic centers known as chakras that are located into the emotional or astral body, in corresponding with the major hormone organs that they are located in our physical body, that brings whatever emotional elements are part of us at a certain point to the physicality, and with the hormones provided by the hormonic glands, this physicality is activated according to the felt emotions. So you can see how these things are interrelated. The spirit is the one, though, that gives the power for the creation. It is also the one that is thinking, which means specifies the creation. Then the emotional body is the result of those formulations, and from the emotional body we go to the physical view that we have, not on the basis of the period, but on the basis of the restrictions we have, we are suffering as a result of our senses. The limitations of our senses becomes an instrument of forming what we perceive that there is here. Enough said about that. I will end up the brief description of this existential body model by reminding you the Aristotle's definition of energy. Basically, the scientific community even now has a problem with the definition of energy. But if you read the metaphysics of Aristotle, you will notice that his definition of energy 2,500 years ago was the following. Energy is something that is transformed, which means becomes, which means that is changing, okay? On the basis of another something that is already active. So, in other words, energy is a substance that changes under the influence of another substance which is already active. What is that substance? That's the big question. That substance is what is really emitted from a spiritual entity that is creating the whole thing. So throughout these descriptions, you will notice again and again and again, I'm going continuously to the point of recognizing the importance of the spirit. Now, for example, I'm talking, when you see a physical body is talking, in reality, the physical body is taking advantage of the soul within the physical body. It is the spirit talking with my voice. The same thing happens when you are talking, when you are listening, the people, what you are really listening is what the spirit within your physical body allows you to listen. So it is the spirit listening, it is the spirit talking, and the rest of the of our component parts, they are just participating into the whole thing. Now, in terms of our the review of the material we have given so far, I will have to give you a brief description of each one of those presentations. The very first one was intelligent design versus natural selection. In other words, the very important question of how the actual transformations occurred into our environment. There are people, many of which are scientists, who believe that there is the whole creation is the result of natural selection, which means accidental changes that happen through some kind of factors that happen for the time being to be active, and they could have been a lot different otherwise, versus the idea that the whole creation is the result of thought, is the result of intelligent design, is the result of an entity, it is a result of some kind of creating power that has the capability to think and also empowers the changes necessary to create it. That's, in a nutshell, the intelligent design proposal. You can think of it differently as well. You can think of it as creationism versus evolution. Now, the creationism is the concept that somebody has the power to create and he's thinking to decide how to create and what to create. Now, versus the evolution, which is talking about random changes evolving under circumstances that they are beyond the control of the result.